Jaguars. Welcome again, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and yes, the rain is falling now, and it is supposed to continue to fall throughout this game. So how do you think that will impact this contest?
Well, first and foremost, both quarterbacks are going to make sure the officials have those dry footballs coming in each and every play and standing over them sometimes with a towel before the center gets up there to snap it. Second thing is the focus of all the guys who handle the football. Do they wear gloves? Do they take them off? Will they carry the ball high and tight to make sure they have good ball security? That's paramount in a game like this.
Get us started is Logan Cook, and off we go from Jacksonville from the 10. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. As Indy's offense takes the field for the first time, we take a look at Matt Ryan, top 10 all-time in passing yards, playing his first career season outside of Atlanta.
And there's a word that constantly gets thrown around with this guy when you talk to anyone in the building. Potential. They are sky high on what they believe he can grow into in the role of a starting quarterback. In addition, there are plenty around the league who think that as well. And years from now, he can still be leading this offense out.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. A carry by Taylor to start the drive. Oh, he's got a little daylight. A big play there on the first play of the game. 43 yards on the ground. So that run there, yeah, I don't know if it's overstating things to call it a thing of beauty, but in terms of football plays, that's as good as you're going to see.
And the thing that stood out to me was his ability to continue through the initial contact. How many times do we see runners get slowed up and not get what they can on a run because of that first contact? But he kept the compass pointing in the right direction, kept the legs churning, and turned this into a huge play.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. They go to the ground again with Taylor. Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and the Jags grab it. And hopefully for both sides, not a sign of things to come, Charles. This morning, it was so perfect outside, but we knew this weather was coming, and we see the effects of it here early on.
And I wonder if how perfect it was this morning has psychologically fooled everyone. You know, it's almost like even though we were told the weather was coming, and you know the teams knew it as well, that maybe they got fooled and thought, ah, it's going to be okay. And now they're probably a little upset that it's out there.
Because warm-ups were dry.
Oh, we're dry. Now you've got to make the change up, and it's the first quarter. Might take them a little time to settle in on their focus and concentration.
Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. And they'll run it. This is James Robinson. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28. Yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. Now Lawrence to throw. His throw incomplete. These two teams, division rivals, of course, and you remember back to Week 18 last year, although Colts fans don't want to remember back to Week 18 last year. The Colts needed a win, and the Jags, they were kind of looking ahead to 2022, but the two-win Jags came up with one of the shockers of the season. They stunned the Colts 26-11 in Jacksonville, and that loss ultimately kept Indianapolis home for the playoffs. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight at just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up fourth down.
On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. Back deep for the Colts, Nyheim Hines. That'll be a 43-yard punt, just a single yard on the return. Second drive coming up here for the Indianapolis Colts. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
So the completion good for 6 yards, and it'll be second down. Nyheim Hines, his first carry, and they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
Sometimes I forget how much information he has to go through before the ball's even snapped, but what a diagnosis right there. Saw the play, shot through the gap like a rocket, ends up spilling it for a loss.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. On fourth down, Matt Hawk is on to punt. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. And a fair catch taken back near about the 35, 36-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. Position for the Jaguars offense as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. Now a throw here to his running back. They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it, and that will bring up second down.
All defense is worried that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it can turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
To throw again on second down, Lawrence. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Engram. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. 3 tight ends. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
Still third down.
Oh, it's a nickel set here defensively on third and inches.
Still want to be prepared for a pass.
Here's Lawrence. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback, and he delivers the ball.
Here's Logan Cook now to punt this one away. 46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. It's a 42-yard punt. They keep him to just a yard on the return. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. We sort of suspected that the elements might wreak havoc on both of these offenses, and that's been the case. No points on either side as this drive begins with a first down. Here's Ryan to throw. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick, and he'll get this back down to about the 12-yard line. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They think they've got not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. They took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. A give left side to Robinson. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Again, it's Robinson. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. They follow up the first down 1-yard run with a minimal gain of 2.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
On third down, Lawrence. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Trevor Lawrence with a hookup to Marvin Jones. And the Jags take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown.
It's never fun for a defense to run on the field knowing that they're having to defend a short field. Just the idea of trying to limit an offense in that position, daunting for a defense.
Riley Patterson now for the extra point. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. From the 10. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And now this offense comes back out onto the field. Now this offense trying to change the script here a little bit, CD, trailing on the scoreboard in the last timeout. On the very first play of the drive, they threw that interception.
And you definitely saw his coaches, teammates come over to him on the sideline, trying to help him shake it off, because in this game, his team is down right now. So it's important to make sure you get some confidence back for both the quarterback and the entire offense. Otherwise, those mistakes could continue to pile up.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. Pierce the intended target there. And now it's second down. Ryan. Now this will be swung out wide for Taylor. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Ryan. And that is incomplete. That makes him out 0 for 2 here in the first quarter on third down conversions.
And now they'll look to their defense because they need them to step up so they don't fall further behind here in the early going.
On fourth down, Matt Hawk to punt it away. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Now fair catch is called for and taken at the, we'll call it the 37-yard line. Not good at all. Punt of just 24 yards there. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. We'll see if they can do better here on this drive. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their 38. They begin the drive with Robinson. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Here's Lawrence to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Now Lawrence. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a 4th down. Well done.
Here's Logan Cook now, as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. 39 yards on the punt, just 2 on the return. And the Colts will go on offense here, 1st and 10. Indy set to go on offense once more. And 3 and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now?
I would say so. And they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
Ryan and the Colts getting set here, 1st and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Now Ryan. Flushed out right. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down. Now it's Ryan. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
That was not a real confident throw right there, and he's just 2 of 7 to start the game. Now he's going to have to find a groove with a big 3rd down coming up. Let's see if his confidence can increase.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Here's Ryan. And this is going to be incomplete.
How about that, Redman? proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
Here's Matt Hawk now to punt. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And that'll hit and go out of bounds, so they'll start just outside their own 40-yard line. The Jaguars back with it on offense. No points last time out. They were forced to punt, if you remember, but no time to dwell on that. They've still got the lead here and a chance to add to that here. First and 10 as this new drive starts. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Now Lawrence. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Looking to throw, Lawrence. Straight, here's Etienne. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. But it looked like a Jaguar was able to cover this thing, and so Jacksonville will keep control. A call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Lawrence will throw. Oh, and that'll be incomplete. He took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Here's Logan Cook now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. On the counter, it's Taylor. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 55 rushing yards rushing for him now. He's only carried the ball four times.
Playing as a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front, and then maybe a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
So first and 10 now from the 30. To throw is Ryan. Rush coming, and he's taken down. They bring a man off the corner that time, and he gets home for a loss of six. Just not much a quarterback can do there, CD. The pressure was in his face almost instantaneously, led to a very quick sack.
Yeah, that's one where you turn to your lineman and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely, because remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
Up the middle, here's Taylor. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. Going to need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. To the right side, complete to Taylor. And this play comes to a halt at the 33, and obviously that's well short of the first down. They do get seven out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Here's Matt Hawk now, as he's on to punt for Indianapolis. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. Lawrence. He's got his tight end. It's Chris Manhertz. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it'll be second down. Straight ahead, ETN. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 6-0, our score after one. Second quarter now from Jacksonville, and it's the Jags with the football. And this offense on third down today, just 1 for 5 to this point. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Looking downfield for Jones. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down.
The offense schemed, going 5 wide, trying to create a chance for the big shot, and they took it. If he comes down with that one, that's a huge offensive swing. But credit the defense with a nice play, knocking that one away.
Now Cook now on to punt as he gets this one away. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there, and they will take over 1st and 10. The Colts now, their offense works their way back onto the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
on first down. This one completes Alec Pierce. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7. On second down, it's Taylor. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
A gain of 5. First down.
A shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
That's one of the dangers of the quick game. If you only have a 2 or 3 step drop, if you don't get the ball to someone open right away, those defenders are right near the line of scrimmage and they get on top of you in a heartbeat.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. He'll find Paris Campbell. That's complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
And there's a first down catch for Paris Campbell. And what a welcome sign for Colts fans who have been waiting for this guy's eventual breakout. Came into the league as a second rounder in 2019 with almost 4.2 speed. Injuries, they've limited him to 15 games in 3 seasons. But the Colts still believe there's a star burner in there if he can stay out there for 17 games.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Here's 2nd and 10 now from the 35. Now it's Ryan. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
He already came through for them on this drive. No surprise that they were hoping he could do it again.
Here comes the 7th play now of this drive as this is 3rd and 10. To throw again is Ryan. He finds Pierce. It's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 20-yard line. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
First and 10, Taylor now. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
If you're going to have a relay race, you're probably going to pick your backs and receivers to run it, but don't underestimate the conditioning of the offensive line. They're out there just dictating things, staying on the field, and keeping a long drive going.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. They run once more with Taylor. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down? From the shotgun, Ryan. And he's going to go down. Sacked right around the 17. Devin Lloyd drops him for a 4-yard loss there, and that brings up 4th down. Well, he shot in, CD, like he was out of a cannon from that linebacker position, and even though they had a running back in the backfield, no one could stop him.
Well, you certainly diagnosed that play perfectly, because as fast as he got into the backfield, you're exactly right. The running back had no shot to get over and try and protect his quarterback, and a sack resulted.
So Ryan heads to the sideline, and out now is Rodrigo Blankenship for the Indianapolis field goal try. And he missed it. It's no good. And the deficit will stay at 2 field goals.
Boy, that's 3 points you really expect to have. That's nothing more than a lack of concentration to me, because an NFL kicker should make this kick in his sleep.
The Jaguars offense now heads back onto the field. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up, first and 10 at their own 24. Here's Lawrence. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Lawrence to throw. And this throw incomplete. The defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Back to throw, Lawrence. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. Had to pass there, third and long on your own side of the field. Just couldn't come up with anything.
That's why teams always talk about having to win the early downs, meaning you've got to gain yardage and set yourself up for third and short, because when it's third and long, the odds go down significantly trying to pick up the first down, even throwing the football.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. So possession goes over here on the punt. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Colts getting another possession here on offense. And the way their last drive ended, boy, it was frustrating. They had a pretty good drive going. It was sustained, and then it stalled out, Charles, and they missed the field goal and got nothing out of it.
Is that insult to injury? Because they had such a sustained drive, as you noted. So you know, for the head coach, it almost felt like a little bit of failure to send out the field goal unit and then to not even see the ball go through the post. What a bummer on that last drive for them. Got to pick themselves up from that one.
And he's going to take this across midfield into Jacksonville territory. 77 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Again, it's Taylor. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? 2nd and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll try the left side with Taylor. And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
Running straight ahead, Taylor. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. He's already fumbled once in this game, and I thought the ball started to jostle there a little bit, but they got to him quickly at the line of scrimmage.
It sure did, and remember, if you're not a very confident runner and you've already dropped it once, if there's traffic around you, the only thing you think about is protecting the football, not gaining yards.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. And that will be incomplete. Jacksonville's pass defense holds serve. Fourth down. So Ryan heads to the sideline, and out now is Rodrigo Blankenship for the Indianapolis field goal try. This from 44 yards out, left hash. And he missed it. That was neither far enough. It wasn't even on target. It's no good, and the deficit will stay at two field goals. So it's a second missed field goal here in this first half. He'll have to think about that going forward. Maybe time for a little soul-searching as well.
Yeah, the head coach might be looking towards the heavens because you wonder if this will affect the fourth down decision-making going forward. If you get fourth and three, fourth and four, situations that used to be calls for the kicker might get a second thought.
Jacksonville back on offense and ready to take over. Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up, first and 10. At the 34. Throwing to start the drive. Lawrence. And he'll be brought down by the Colts. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. I think that time he just maybe held on to it a little too long, CD, because after a couple of seconds in this league, you know those defenders are coming.
And how many times did we talk about complementary football? And we usually talk about, does the offense help the defense? Does the defense help the offense? I think in this case, does the quarterback help out his offensive line? You only have a certain amount of time to get rid of the football. They can only do so much. On this play, he took them to the limits.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, what they call play side. But how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key the left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want that left tackle, if you bring your tight end over there. Either way, control the edge of the line of scrimmage, you got a chance to rumble.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
He took a shot there, but boy, was that ill-advised from my viewpoint. Coverage was awfully tight. How did he get away with that one not being picked off?
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Second down and a run by Robinson. And he's down right around midfield after a gain of two, maybe three. The offense on third down, it's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. From midfield now, Lawrence. It's caught inside the 25. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 21. A very well-executed play. It goes for 29 yards. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. Caught on the right side by Jones. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
Now Lawrence. And he wisely will throw that one away. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, 2nd and goal. Again, it's Lawrence. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Two incompletions haven't moved him any closer. And likely throwing again, you'd have to think, on 3rd and goal here. Here's Lawrence to throw. And he's going to go down, sacked right around the 17. That's Yannick Ngakoue with a sack. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
Riley Patterson now on for the field goal. This will be a 34-yard attempt. And this is going to be no good. That was short. Not even on target either, but it was short. And this will stay a 1-score game as the lead will hold at 6. So 1st and goal quickly turns into 4th and goal, and then 4th and goal turns into no points whatsoever.
That's a very disappointing sequence of events right there. And I, for one, would not want to be the kicker as to run over to his head coach and explain that one.
Indianapolis offense ready to go again. And last time out, another missed field goal. So maybe their confidence wavering a little bit right now in the kicking game.
And I'm with you on that. I think at this stage, they'd love to not run him back out there in a tough situation. But let's face it, they may have to. So right now, the head coach is talking to the offense coordinator and saying, call this game like we're going to put it in the end zone. Let's try and take the field goal out of it.
They'll start on the ground here on 1st down. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down. It's a pickup of 3, and we have now arrived at the 2-minute warning. Balled at the 26, 2nd and 7. Here's Ryan. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Hits his target, the tight end, Mo Alley Cox. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On fourth down, Matt Hawk is on to punt. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. On the return, here's Agnew. A pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. And they have to feel like they missed on an opportunity for points last time when they couldn't connect on that short field goal try.
And no doubt about it, because they were counting on those points. In today's NFL, let's face it, that's really a chip shot, right?
That's anything inside 40.
Yeah, they're counting on that going through the post. But we've seen it happen to teams before. Some of the best kickers in the world can miss kicks like that. Can they come back now and redeem themselves?
Now Lawrence, thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Kenny Moore. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
After the interception, here's Ryan. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. Pierce the intended target there. And that'll bring up second down. Ryan. That one finds Pierce right side. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Michael Pittman that time, but it'll be second down. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
Feels like we're getting caught in between here, because any completions on first and second down, now you got to worry a little bit about the clock, because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Again, Ryan. And the throw there going to be incomplete. Jacksonville's pass defense holds serve. Fourth down. So Ryan heads to the sideline, and out now is Rodrigo Blankenship for the Indianapolis field goal try. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And that is not going to get there. Oh, he missed it short. It's no good. And the deficit will stay at two field goals. So that now three misses here in this first half.
And the important thing is you just can't get discouraged. You may still have some chances to make amends in the second half, so you've got to get yourself in the right frame of mind to get the job done.
The Jags going to go on offense now late in this first half. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there. There will be second down. Pretty fortunate there. The interception that ended the last drive, and then boom, the first pass here almost picked on this drive.
Yeah, I think you could definitely call him to question his decision-making here in the first half.
Certainly not the best of decisions there. Lucky that one wasn't picked. Again on second and 10, it's Lawrence. Over the middle, he's got his tight end, Ingram. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Now Lawrence on first down. This one complete to Christian Kirk. And he's going to have a first down here as they're also into field goal range at the 28. On play action, Lawrence. Flush to his right. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked off by Isaiah Rogers. And the Colts are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line.
Partner, have you ever heard the story of Icarus in mythology? That's the guy who flew too close to the sun and had his wings melted. That was our guy right there. Keeps pressing it and pressing it. Finally, on that throw, he paid the price with that turnover.
Well, the white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So we have reached halftime in what's a six-point game at the break. As we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome everyone to our brand-new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, a check of the next-gen stats in that first half for the Colts. And even though they trail, they've had success running the football, over 100 yards rushing as a team in those first two quarters of play. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, you get a look at what they were able to do throwing the football. And whatever they've done, it's worked, as they have the lead through two quarters of play.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter of what's been a tight contest so far. Same, the rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Fields this way up at the 17. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Jaguars ready to get going to start quarter number three. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it. But I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities. And I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Second half begins with a run by Robinson. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a low and on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now Lawrence. And Jones has it over the middle. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Running out of the gun with ETN. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Defense doing their job. Really nowhere to run the football.
Yeah, it's almost textbook, wasn't it? Every place he tried to find an open spot, there just wasn't one. Congrats to the defense. No gain.
Call fitting your gaps, right?
I love it. You're exactly right.
Lawrence will throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game, because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
On third down, Lawrence. And that is incomplete. Here's Logan Cook now, as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. Hines now on the return. A nice return that time of about 14 yards. Here's the Colts now as they get ready for their first possession on offense of the second half. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
Ryan and the Colts getting set here, first and 10 at the 34. He'll start with a give to Taylor. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. They go to the ground again with Taylor, and he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. After a gain of five, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down. They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 116 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 16 times.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Oh. Play action. It's Ryan. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. This is Hines. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
They'll need the 39 here for a first. This is third down. Now Ryan. He finds Pierce. It's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 34-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, and that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. On the handoff, Taylor. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4. Here's Ryan to throw. And his throw is incomplete. This will be play number 9 of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. Now it's Ryan. Now that's into the hands of Mo Alie-Cox, the tight end. And he is going to have a Colts first down by about a yard. It's a gain of 5 on 3rd and 4.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. 3rd and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
Now Ryan on first down. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
From the 24, they'll go again on 2nd and 10. Play action, Ryan. And his throw here is incomplete.
That play call wasn't there for them against that coverage. So they're going to spin the dial now in their playbook and come up with one more shot at the marker to try and keep this series going.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Throwing again, Ryan. And he's got Pierce. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
A field goal helps, but a touchdown gets you the lead. That had to be the message transmitted in the huddle. And they delivered there as that throw is going to keep the drive alive. And even better than that, set them up with a 1st and goal.
So another 3rd down conversion, and now they've got a 1st and goal. Here's Ryan. And he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. Mo Alie-Cox from 4 yards. one down. And the Colts have tied the ball game with a chance to take the lead. Well, they were down 6 at intermission, but they quickly erased that deficit. And, Charles, now they've got a chance to take the lead.
And while being down 6 points, obviously not an insurmountable lead, tying a game up, that just relaxes a whole team, doesn't it? And now when you have the extra point, you go up, you really feel good about what you've accomplished.
The point after through the raindrops, up and good. And they take the lead here at 7-6. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. A short kick taken at the 18. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Jags offense now gets set and heads back onto the field. A last series form, a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, 1st and 10. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up, 1st and 10, right at the 30. Now a handoff to start it out. Robinson trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. So nothing there that time, and maybe you need to look to the O-line. They weren't able to create any space.
No, they weren't, and you know as well as I do, as many offensive line coaches we've ever met, I think that'll be addressed loudly when those guys get to the sideline.
And they're usually loud and big. Lawrence's throw into the hands of Kirk. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Lawrence finding Kirk there for the Jaguar first. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. And one more time, here's Kirk. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it'll be 2nd down.
Gotta love a guy who'll stand in there and deliver. No matter what the pressure, waits for the route to come open, hangs in there, and completes the pass.
Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
And when the defense wins and gives up no yardage on a running play, that's something they can build on and carry themselves forward throughout the game.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. You got a young quarterback. You know, maybe that's just an example of a growing pain for him.
I think you're right about that, because when the game starts to move fast and it moves quickly on him, a lot of times they fall back on what they know best, their arm. He's slinging it on this one. Had a wide open target, but didn't have the proper footwork to increase his accuracy.
So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. And this returnable for Hines. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And the Colts will go on offense here, 1st and 10. Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. Ryan and the Colts getting set here, first and 10 at their own 22. A carry by Taylor to start the drive. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 137 yards for him on the ground now on 18 carries.
Anytime you hear the term an explosive run, most teams I know define that as any run over 10 yards, and they got that and more. How about a lot of credit for the big guys up front? That offensive line firing out, creating plenty of space, and a big run ensued.
One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. Now a give to Taylor. And some space here. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Boy, a pair of big plays here. This one going for 29. Thought they were going to have him down a lot earlier, but he was able to shed that tackle.
Shows the value of the weight room, doesn't it? Shows the value of the attitude when you run the football. Don't go down easily. Brickles gain some additional yardage.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 34. To throw is Ryan. He'll drop this down to Taylor. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find answers, and they've got to find them quick.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. On the handoff, this is Taylor. A second fake. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
The running game's played a huge part in getting him down to this point on the field. I say stay with it. Keep pounding the football. Keep driving. Keep grinding.
Yeah, even down in the red zone, keep going for it.
No doubt about it. With what brung you.
They'll run here with Taylor. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. It's a jet sweep. This is Pittman. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
Well, they've gotten it down to the 3, but now this is third and goal. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On third and goal, Ryan. He'll get this off to Taylor. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. They're able to hold him to 3 there, and that leads to a fourth and goal.
Oh, my, that's a heck of a tackle right there on third down because they had to swing it out to the back and hope that he could make a play. But let's face it, in order for him to be there and be in that position, in order to make that play, he had to read his keys and not be fooled. Excellent job in the open field.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to get the lead up to 4. Blankenship's kick is good. And they bump the lead up to 4 now at 10-6. So it was fourth and one down in the red zone, but they elect to take just the three.
And I'm a little surprised that that's how they decided to play it, that they didn't go for it there. But sometimes just take those 3 points and put them in your pocket. I just have one question for you, partner.
Okay.
Hip pocket or back pocket?
After the made field goal, here's Blankenship again. This one taken just inside the 10. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Here's Lawrence to throw. Caught by Jones. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped out. A guy can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Throwing again on second down. Lawrence, his throw incomplete. He was looking for Travis Etienne out of the backfield, and it's third and short. Looking to throw, Lawrence. And that is incomplete. That close on third down. I think everybody probably expecting a run. Instead, they go to the air on third and short yardage.
I realize this is a passing league, and they're liable to throw the ball on any down and distance. But that short, I do question the call. Run the football and pick it up.
They'll run for it with Robinson. And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. He needed a yard. He didn't get anything. And the Colts are going to get the football in outstanding field position. Well, they've clearly made a conscious decision here to be more aggressive in the late stages of this game here in the second half.
And I get it. In this situation, you know, if you want to be aggressive out near midfield, you feel good about your defense maybe, or just, hey, I thought I had a proper play call. But how about the guys that just stopped them? How good do they feel right now? Hey, you want to go for it here? We shut you down? They're over on the bench right now feeling great.
Up the middle, here's Taylor. 5 yards on the carry, good up on first down. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
Now it's Hines. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup. Moves him to third and one. Heavy set out there on third and one. Now a handoff. Taylor with it. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down.
One thing I do know that offensive linemen like, they like a guy who's carrying the ball that will take what is blocked. Not try and create a big play and maybe take a loss. Not try and go where the blocking isn't. But if it's just all that's there and you just put your head and your shoulders down and get that, you get the respect of the big guys up front.
Right now, let's go.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Ryan hits his target, the tight end Mo Alie-Cox. And he's going to get this down near the 25.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2 at the 25-yard line.
Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. From the gun, it's Taylor. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down. Again, it's Taylor. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
On second down, it's Taylor. And they'll get him down right around the 16. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. Here's Ryan. The pass underneath. Here's Hines with it. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And that certainly appears to be a critical right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Got a man, it's Pittman, and he holds it in for the Colts touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown pass. And the Colts get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. But that makes this a 2-score ball game. And, you know, the way this thing has been going, Charles, 2 scores kind of feels like 3 or 4 scores.
Yeah, that's a great observation. It's been a heck of a battle, hasn't it? And points have been at a premium throughout this game. So you have to wonder, is this going to be too much for them to overcome?
And it's no good. Oh, he misses the extra point. And our score stays where it is. Back out, boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. From the 6. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Jaguars getting set to go. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up, first and 10. Right at the 30. Here's Lawrence. He completes it to Jones. That'll go for a gain of 7, and it's second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Second down and 3. A shotgun snap and a give to ETN. And some good acceleration there as he's across midfield to the 48-yard line. That one a pickup of 15 for Jacksonville. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. That's complete to Travis Etienne out of the backfield. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. 23 yards, the final tally.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least three here to get it back to a one-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle, that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back again.
And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. Etienne bringing in another one. Short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22. Etienne up the middle. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
All runners count on their eyes to find the gaps and creases, to find open space. There was absolutely none on that one. Totally swallowed up on that play.
On third down, Lawrence. On the slant, he'll get it to Jones. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. From the shotgun, Lawrence. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Touchdown! Christian Kirk on the receiving end of that touchdown pass from Trevor Lawrence. And the Jaguars have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long because they...
Oh, this is blocked. The Colts have it. And now the rookie's free. He's at the 50, 30, 10, 5, and he takes it the distance across the goal line for 2 points. That is a play that you just do not see very often, maybe a couple times a year, the blocked extra point return for two.
You can't afford to give anyone a free run at the kicker. Oftentimes, he's going to bounce off his hands or chest and head the other direction.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Now Jonathan Taylor and the Colts offense retake center stage. He has a chance to hit that often elusive 200-yard mark on high.
And most of the time during a game, people aren't keeping track of individual statistics.
Are you sure?
Well, a lot of the runners kind of know. But I'll guarantee you, someone has sent word into the offensive line that he's got a chance to get over 200 on this drive. That should give them a little extra motivation because they love it when backs break that barrier.
Absolutely. We'll see if he can do it. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And it's nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. A turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
They give to Taylor out of the gun. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down. The objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right. But the problem for them is still within a possession. So they can't just sit on it running the ball. They have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
On third down, Ryan. And this is going to be incomplete. And sensing the momentum maybe changing here a little bit, Charles.
Yeah, this defense is going to get off the field quickly, and their offense got them a touchdown last time they had the ball, so they should get another shot.
Here's Matt Hawk now as they're forced to kick for the sixth time today. Agnew now to return. A 39-yard punt, a return of five. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here.
A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now, but let's give credit where because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football.
Buying time to his left. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
And next time, Brandon, I think you might want to consider running it because those defensive backs, they were plastered to the receivers and they weren't letting up as that play went on.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10.
Now Lawrence.
Looking sideline, incomplete. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Lawrence being chased out left. And that's incomplete.
That is certainly one way to frustrate a quarterback. Run those extra defenders on the field. Dime package, lots of speed, face to fit in the football.
Here we go, gotta have it, Lawrence.
And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Well, they've got the slim deficit, decided to go for it, hoping to keep the football score and erase that deficit. But, boy, deep in their own territory like that.
Let's just say that with that call, me and the head coach will agree to disagree. All right, but he knew he wanted aggressive there, as you pointed out. So I guarantee he told his defensive coordinator, have your guys up and ready. I'm going to go for it here. If we don't get it, just make sure they're ready to go out there and bail us out.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. First and 10, Taylor now.
He'll get about six there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Oh, and fine work there as he gets this thing down to the 11-yard line. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They run once more with Taylor. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Jonathan Taylor taking it in from 11 yards out as his guys are able to extend their lead. What a huge touchdown that was, obviously, here in the late stages of the fourth quarter as they try to put this one away.
And, Brandon, when they watch the film after this week, they'll be very proud of every rep if they close this game out. Just a few snaps remaining. They can't relax just yet.
The Colts will line up for the two-point conversion.
To throw for it is Ryan. And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack, and they fail on the try for two.
But they tried to get two and ended up getting none because the quarterback had nowhere to go with the ball and ends up getting sacked.
Nowhere to go at all. Great job, though, defensively. They were ready. To throw for it is Ryan. And so after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. This is taken just shy of the 10. And he won't quite make it to the 25. So here now, Lawrence and the Jaguars. Down by 12. 1:47 on the clock. Field goals useless at this point. They need two touchdowns, and they need them in short order. On first and 10, it's Lawrence. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
But they've certainly had trouble blocking this defense through 3.5 quarters, so I don't expect it to get any easier now. You know they're going to be sitting back and waiting on everything, and they force an incompletion there.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Lawrence will throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movements. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Well, throws like that, especially where we sit in the fourth quarter, he's got to be careful.
Yeah, and you know one of my faults is that I often view this game through a defensive back's eyes. And in this situation, your team's losing, it's late, tighter coverage, take a chance and go and try and step in front of one of those and make a big play. So if you're the quarterback, that should be in your head. This is their time to take a gamble.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Now Lawrence to throw. And this is intercepted, and that should do it.
Picked off by Isaiah Rodgers. And the Colts are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line.
Partner's bad enough when you just can't hold on to the football. But when your quarterback's throwing it to the other team, that's three interceptions now, four turnovers for the game. You really have no chance to win the football game.
Here comes the Colts offense now as they make their way onto the field. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. Good starting field position for the Colts as they have it first and 10 at their own 37. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. The Colts in victory formation now as they take the knee. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. The Colts in victory formation now as they take the knee. And the Jags, Charles, I think they're in the dime here.
Covering a lot of field.
Ryan heads down to a knee, and that should wrap this one up.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop tell me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one. On is the punter, Hawk, as he gets this one away. Well, somebody lit a fire under that offense during the break, Charles. Remember, they trailed at intermission. They come out. They
changes, just have to do it a little bit better, a little cleaner. And they did that in the second half, and that led them to victory.